Welcome back to our e-telecast, God Has a Word for You, and I'm Pastor Aminata. And our subject is faith walker or faith talker. And we've been looking at faith, basically, and trying to glean an understanding of exactly what it is. Last time we realized and discovered that faith, the word faith, was only used 2 times in the Old Testament. Now, somebody should have a question right about now, but wait a minute. If the word faith, wait a minute, didn't we hear something about Abraham and faith? Let's go to Hebrews, the 11th chapter, okay? So come go with me. Hebrews 11 and the 11th chapter. And no, we're not doing Hebrews 11, 1. We're not ready for that yet. So let's just look at this. Starting at the 3rd verse. By faith, we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God, so that the things which are seen were not made of things which are visible. So even for us to accept the world is only by faith. If we believe God, we believe that God made the world. Well, it's through faith. But let's go down. It says, by faith, Abel offered to God a more excellent sacrifice. That's verse 4. Let's skip to verse 5. By faith, Enoch was translated so that he did not see death. So, by faith, Abel, by faith, Enoch. Let's skip down some more to 7. By faith, Noah, being divinely warned of things not yet seen. This is deep. Noah, being divinely warned of things not yet seen, moved with godly fear, which means reverence, all right, prepared an ark for the saving of his household. By faith, Noah did all that. By getting a revelation of things that wasn't even seen, but he moved on it. Let's keep going. 8. By faith, Abraham obeyed when he was called to go out to the place which he would afterwards receive an inheritance. Verse 11. By faith, Sarah herself also received strength to conceive seed by faith. I tell you, the Bible is saying that all these people and more, right? This is the testimony. This is their witness. They all moved by faith. And even though the word faith wasn't used. So then if the word faith wasn't used, then what is faith? What exactly does it mean? And I think that once we get that, that's really going to help us understand. You know, we're in church so much that we hear stuff and it's in one ear and out the next. We don't stop to say, okay, I got this. You don't got it unless you can actualize it in your life, period. Unless you take what you hear and say, I want that working for me, then we don't really have it. But there's a definition here in my Bible that I want to read to you. So listen to this. Faith is defined in a practical way in Hebrews 11. Of course, you know, faith is the substance of things hoped for, evidence not seen, yada, yada, yada. But it goes on to say this. What is faith? It is confidence that someone or something is reliable. Our whole life is based on faith. Without it, banks and post offices would not be possible. Paper money and credit cards, the very word credit is from the Latin verb to believe, would never be accepted. The very word credit is from the Latin verb to believe. Isn't that something? So we must have some content to our Christianity. Paul puts the fact of the faith in a nutshell. He says this, that Christ died for our sins according to the scriptures, and that he was buried, and that he rose again the 3rd day according to the scriptures. See, again, if we believe this, and that should be the fundamental of your faith factor. Just the mere fact that we believe that Christ died for our sins and rose again on the 3rd day. If I can believe that, If I can believe that God made the heavens and the earth, and you know, I have no other proof but just my belief, because that's what faith is, my trust, my belief, and trust in God. Let's do it again. Faith is my belief and my trust in God. One more time. Faith is my belief and my trust in God. I believe and I trust that He saved me. I believe and I trust that He sent His Son to die for me. I believe and I trust that He can do whatever else that needs to be done in my life. Are you getting it now? Can you see this thing? By faith, Abraham did. By faith, Abel did. By faith, Enoch did. By faith, Noah did. By faith, Sarah did. By faith, not seeing, but believing and trusting. Hallelujah. Oh, I'm getting excited, y'all. That's what faith is. And if sometimes we have a tendency to not remember, or we forget, or we lose that little piece, so we always should go back to the beginning. Where was I when I ran to Christ? Where was I? What was my life like when I was out there in the world and I was without Him? But I ran to Him, and it was my faith. I used my faith and said, Lord, here I am, a sinner, save me. It was faith. And we're going to look at that too when we come back. Because remember, Jesus said in Luke 18 and 8, but when I, the Son of Man, return, how many will I find who have faith? I'm Pastor Aminata. We'll be back again, because God has a word for you.
You haven't yet accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, let's do so right now with this prayer of salvation. Pray after me, but it's more important that you believe it in your heart. Father God, I believe your word, and your word says that if I confess with my mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in my heart that God has raised Him from the dead, that I will be saved. So right now I put my trust in you, Jesus Christ, as my personal Lord and Savior. I admit that I'm a sinner and that I need God in my life. So I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of the living God. Amen. So if you prayed that prayer, I want you to drop us a line and email us and let us know, because right now you are saved and the angels in heaven are rejoicing. And do yourself a huge favor and find yourself a Bible-believing church and continue to grow in grace. God bless you.